Hey, what's happening, everybody? This is Robert the Leather Cowboy Muhammad here at Premier Leather Crafters down here in the dirty, where it is. We had a massive snowstorm. Guess what it is? Whatever it is, you know, down here in Alabama, we really are not fully used to snow and people just panic. So, for one, as a crafter, it was a great time for me to lock in and get caught up on some projects because everything just shut down. But while I'm waiting on a piece to finish casing, I thought I'd just drop this quick video real fast. Somebody in the Leathers Guild had a question. And I thought it was very important. Even though nobody responded to it, except a couple of people. And I think they was just giving their preference more than actually answering the question itself. So I thought it would be a great time to do this little quick video because I know that it is a lot of newer crafters that's out there that may have the same thing. Or they might be doing this and don't even know that they're doing it. But rubber cement versus contact cement. And the question was, why would I use one over the other? And what would be the purpose for using one over the other? So, with that being said, hence the video. Now, most of your more experienced crafters or people who've been crafting this for a while, first, let me tell you about rubber cement. Rubber cement is not a permanent gluing process, especially when you're doing work that requires bending or work that requires forming. For instance, this wallet here that I'm working on, new wallet for the Cowboy Series. Now, I'm just going to give you a brief illustration because I'm still waiting for this to case. Actually, I'm just about ready to finish this. But anyway, your insides, the interior part of this wallet, I will rubber cement. I will line everything up, make sure that everything is all lined up and perfect. And then as I start to bend this and get this into place, I want my wallet to... I want my completed wallets to stay bent. I don't want them to open back out flat. I want them to stay, to have some type of forming and shaping. So I will take my rubber cement and I will rubber cement the whole entire thing, the whole entire inside. And I will start to form that. Now to get that bend or to maintain that bend in this wallet, I'll rubber cement that, and then rubber cement, the great part about rubber cement is you can pull it apart. So once I pull that side apart, and I'm going to tack this down with my clips, and I have several, maybe about 100 of those, and I have several of the other little kind, too, the little real strong paper clips. But I would take that and these little numbers here. You can buy these at any Walmart or Office Depot, But I would, once I rubber cement this one side, I'll clamp it down. And after I clamp that down, then I can bend this. And what rubber cement will allow me to do is to pull the other side apart. And then I can reshape it and get it to have and maintain that bend. That's the great part about rubber cement. Prime example, cuffs. Things that you need to have to maintain their shape. Rubber cement first. And your rubber cement one part of that. Or you can even contact cement the part that you know is going to be stationary. The part that you don't want to pull off. And I would rubber cement or contact cement probably about maybe a quarter of this. And then go ahead and attach it. Rubber cement the rest. And then what I would do then, once I get it to go on my wrist, I can, this doesn't maintain the shape by itself. You have to pull that excess out with your rubber cement. And that's what the rubber cement is going to allow you to do. It's going to allow you to shape it, and you can pull that extra out of there. And normally you can cut, like on my wallets, I can cut my interior the exact size, but once I fold it, it's going to have me an excess of probably about a half to a 1 inch excess on there. And that's because I'm going to pull this and reform it and reshape it. And then once I get that reformed and reshaped, then I'll cut that excess off. And then I'll come back and peel it back. And then I'll contact cement the rest of it. And then that's once you contact cement, that's a permanent setting. It's going to permanently be there. So you won't be able to pull it apart and get it correct size. So the thing is, and I guess in other words to say is, rubber cement, temporary. Contact cement, permanent. You can't do a uh-oh or oops. Once you contact cement it, it's on there, it's not going anywhere, and it's done data, done deal. So the reason, there is not a reason to choose one over the other, because I personally believe crafters need to use both. I would suggest you use both. And that rubber cementing is going to allow you to pull and stretch. Now, even with this wallet, I would contact cement this portion because I want this part to be permanent. So I'm going to mate up the interior part with this to be a perfect sizing, and then I will rubber cement this part because it's cool for me to have access or excess on this end of the wallet. Is this, that's no problem because I'm going to trim it and shape it, and it's a flat surface. Over here, I don't want excess on this side because it's going to throw off the designing of the wallet, because all of my measurements will be off. So if I go to pull in this end, it's going to make this come out to here. You see what I'm saying? So now I want to contact cement this end, leave this permanent, and I'll probably run contact cement all the way up to here, all the way up to about this much of the wallet. And then I'll rubber cement the rest so I can pull it and make it and have my wallet maintain its shape. Once I do that, then I'll trim off the extra and then go back and contact cement that. I hope you guys understood exactly what I was trying to say. But there is not a contact cement versus rubber cement. There's no such thing. You need both of them. I think you even need both of them. When you are making projects that require bending or forming, yes, especially if you want to get off into doing gun holsters, if you want to get off into making gun holsters, where you're going to have to bend that leather around that weapon, you want to be able to pull that excess tight so the holster can maintain its shape. The same way right here, because leather is just flat. It's just flat. So to get it to maintain that shape like that, once you put your lining in there, even if you're using pig lining, deer skin lining, whatever you're going to use as a liner, you still will want to contact cement that and pull it, and then get it to take the shape that you want it to take, and then contact cement it. Once you contact cement it, then you can go in and do your whatever stitching, lacing, or whatever you're going to do to complete your project. Hey, this is the Leather Cowboy, Robert Muhammad, down here in the Dirty Dirty with Premier Leather Crafters. Thank you guys for chilling with me for these 9.5 minutes, and I hope that answers your question. Leather crafters need to use both. I think need to use both. I use both depending on if it's work that's going to require bending or shaping or forming that I want to stay folded. Oh man, and I thought that I had my minimalist wallet here, and it would give you a perfect example of that. But anything that requires bending and I want to stay bent or folded, That's, or even round it. Contact cement first, pull all your excess off, cut it, trim it, then contact cement. So rubber cement first, then contact cement. Contact cement is going to make it a permanent hole for you guys. Hey, see you guys on the other side. Hope that this helped you out. And anytime, always click the subscription button below. And every time that I do one of these videos, it'll send you an email to let you know, hey, look, something new's popped up, or some new questions might be out there need to be answered. Or you can always drop a comment in the comment section below, and I'll try my utmost best to answer those questions for you within a timely manner. See you guys on the other side. Peace.